What will the state budget process mean for education funding in Pennsylvania? I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me this hour is Pennsylvania State Representative Jim Roebuck. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
Let's talk a little bit about the different components of education funding. There's higher ed funding, and there's also basic ed funding. Let's first start with higher ed funding. They're state-related. There are state universities. Let's talk a little bit about that and what that means. The governor has called for cuts there. What will those cuts mean for those schools, and what schools are we actually talking about?
Well, he's called for very dramatic cuts. You talk about the state-related and the state system. You're talking about University of Pittsburgh, Penn State, Temple, Lincoln, which are at one tier. Their appropriations have been cut in half. If you go down to the state system, the old, what we used to call the state teachers college system, Westchester, Cheney, Mooresville, Lock Haven, that 14 tier of schools, those have also been cut in half. The reality is that puts pressure on those institutions in terms of having enough money to function properly. It means that they're going to, in turn, need to increase tuition. It also means that in some cases, the colleges that are perhaps financially weaker are in jeopardy of closing. So you might see some of the state system colleges actually closing. And some of the branch campuses of the large universities, some of the branch campuses of Pittsburgh and Penn State will probably close. So it's a devastating impact, and it reduces the opportunity for young people to access higher education.
But what options are there, though, in light of the budget challenges that the state is facing? Are there opportunities to reinstate some of this funding? Are there ways to take funding from other areas in order to put it back for higher education?
I would believe there should be no higher priority than funding higher education. If we're talking about developing an educated, well-skilled workforce, then we need young people to have the opportunity to go to college and get the level of education they need to be successful. It's ironic to me that we're talking about reducing education while at the same time we're increasing funding for prisons. And we now are spending over $30,000, $35,000 a year for each prisoner, and we're reducing funding for education. We're making it more difficult for young people who want to succeed, who work hard to get an education.
So let's talk a little bit about basic education and the basic ed subsidy, and this is K-12 funding. What will happen in the budget process moving for education funding for districts throughout the Commonwealth? What do you anticipate happening there?
The governor has proposed an over $1 billion cut in the basic education subsidy. That means that many school districts will not have the resources they need. Many of the innovative programs that were developed over the last 8 years under the Rendell administration will be lost. We're going to see school districts hard-pressed to maintain levels of teachers in the classroom. Programs that are innovative and helpful to students are going to disappear. We have become a leader in areas of educational progress. We're the only state in the nation that's shown consistent improvements in achievement levels of students across all the grade levels. We have become a leader in pre-kindergarten education. Before Ed Rendell became governor, we put no money into pre-kindergarten. We're now a national leader in that area. All of that is now in jeopardy.
And we just have a short time left, but would this cut in funding take Pennsylvania back to pre-stimulus education funding? Is that the idea?
We'll take it back even further. And in terms of the actual progress we made, we're taking us back probably to about 2000, the actual levels of funding go back to pre-stimulus. But if you measured by the progress we made, then indeed it's even further back.
And just a very short time left, but Senate Bill 1 related to school vouchers for certain districts in Pennsylvania, what kind of impact would that have?
That further drains money out of the education system. We're talking about ultimately in excess of $1 billion going into money from the public to finance private education.
Come back, give us an update. Let us know how this budget conversation is progressing.
Thank you. I would be glad to do that.
Thank you. We've been talking with Pennsylvania State Representative Jim Roebuck. I'm Jill Horner.